by another 3 to 5 degrees as we get away from Lake Erie coming down the 50.
Here it is. The news about the coronavirus. That's right. The news about the coronavirus.
Remember, starting off near 60, already by 9 o'clock, we're nearing mid-70s. That's where we'll be for your lunch hour. From there, we'll see those temperatures continue to climb a bit through the afternoon, working their way into the lower 80s for many of us tomorrow. And some of us will be flirting with mid-80s in the forecast as well. Akron Canton, 84 for your high tomorrow. 85 is where we're headed for Mansfield. And even right along the lakeshore, temperatures will be cooler, but I'm still forecasting 80s across the board. So 80 tomorrow for Mentor, as well as Ashtabula for your highs. From there, we're going to see a big spike in our temperatures coming our way on Wednesday, jumping by about 10 degrees to a high of 91. Notice there's a little bit of a dip in here Wednesday or Thursday, Friday, but that's only because we're reintroducing chances for showers and thunderstorms late in the afternoon, early into the evening, so that won't allow our readings to warm up quite as much. However, 90s are back for that weekend forecast. More details on your Saturday, Sunday coming up in less than 10 minutes. Got your storm track Doppler radar. Navy. The new height of black woman is setting in the military. Next.
With Spectrum Mobile, what you see is what you get. That means no added taxes or fees. Get an unlimited data plan for just $45 a month per line. That includes unlimited talk and text, too. You can save up to 40% on your mobile bill, and there are no contracts. Experience the fastest overall speeds and the most reliable mobile service coast to coast with Spectrum Mobile. Now the fastest growing mobile provider in the nation. Learn more at SpectrumMobile.com.
Always Ohio, always refreshing, always on. We are Spectrum News One, exclusively on Spectrum. Sunday mornings, take an in-depth look at your community. In Focus with Mike Kallmeyer, a half-hour show dedicated to the important issues. Driven to bring decision-makers together and committed to elevating discussion and debate. Your community, your state, your show. In Focus with Mike Kallmeyer, Sunday mornings at 10:30 on Spectrum News One. Exclusively on Spectrum.
Weather in Ohio is changing all the time.
We get winter one day and 60s the next. At Spectrum News One, our goal is refreshingly simple.
We bring you an accurate, reliable, and local forecast every 10 minutes.
We have an incredible, experienced team of people. We don't just know about the weather, we know about Ohio.
You never have to wait for your forecast with your Weather on the Ones.
Weather on the Ones, every 10 minutes, exclusively on Spectrum.
So this is Eva, and she goes everywhere with me. Like her, I have this innate sense of curiosity. I really like meeting new people. I love to explore, and right now I'm trying to travel to every national park across the country. Every morning, that same curiosity is what drives me as a journalist.
News One, I'm Cynthia Constantine.
It really fuels the type of stories that we do. It defines us as Ohioans, and it's why I'm so excited to call this place home.
In recorded history, a black woman is set to be a U.S. Navy tactical pilot. Naval Air Training Command is congratulating Lieutenant Madeline Sweeble. In a tweet, it says she's receiving her Wings of Gold this month. The military magazine Stars and Stripes says she'll likely fly Super Hornets, Growlers, or Joint Strike Fighters.
Washington Redskins are changing their name. Today, the football team announcing they will be officially retiring the name Redskins, as well as their current logo. Many have called for the team to make the change amidst rallies for racial justice nationally, citing the racist nature of the name. The new name and logo has not been announced. They concluded their statement, saying in part, Dan Snyder and Coach Rivera are working closely to develop a new name and design approach that will enhance the standing of our proud tradition-rich franchise. A passion for fashion mixed with art. The college graduate exploring a new business opportunity coming up next in today's Ohio Stories. But first, Ashley.
Relatively comfortable temperatures out there this afternoon, but we've got 90s making a comeback to our forecast. I'll let you know how much longer we have before that surge in temperatures arrives. That's just ahead in your next Weather on the One.
Get excited. The plays, the rush, cheers, and the tradition. Get ready to put your business inside the action. Everyone is here for the experience. Because wherever your customers are watching, that's the stadium. Advertising live events and coverage is our favorite sports return team. Expect to reach. We fan together.
Give me an opportunity to see every corner of the state. I want to empower our communities and redefine what a news channel can be.
Every morning, the people of Ohio have the opportunity to wake up and start fresh.
We want to be a different kind of news channel, putting storytelling and community first.
Well, it's really humbling to be invited to our neighbors' homes and help them plan their day.
Welcome to your morning news. I'm Sophia Constantine.
Let's take a look at your weather on the one. You've got a large band of precipitation.
The world.
Your morning news. Weekday mornings on Spectrum News One. Sunday mornings. Take an in-depth look at your community. In Focus with Mike Kallmeyer. A half-hour show dedicated to the important issues. Driven to bring decision makers together. And committed to elevating discussion and debate. Your community. Your state. Your show. In Focus with Mike Kallmeyer. Sunday mornings at 10:30 on Spectrum News One. Exclusively on Spectrum.
Maybe I'll run for president. Maybe I won't. But I will tell you that I'm not going to go away.
Here it is. The news about the coronavirus. That's right. The news about the coronavirus.
Conversations Sunday and Tuesday night at 9 on Spectrum News One, exclusively on Spectrum.
Ohio, I'm meteorologist Ashley Bating, and it's an absolutely gorgeous afternoon out there. Your evening looking very pleasant as well, with only minimal rain chances in the forecast for us through the rest of the evening. Maybe a quick little spot shower is going to be possible, but by and large, we're dry and really comfortable this evening with those temperatures after sunset falling off pretty quickly, particularly away from the lakeshore. We're pretty rapidly after sunset. We're going to see temperatures coming back down into the 60s. For areas right along the lake, it's not going to cool off quite that quickly, but we're still in for a very pleasant evening. Let me walk you through it. Readings in the mid-70s by 7 o'clock this evening. From there, temperatures falling off a little bit more sharply after 9 o'clock, and then we'll ultimately wind up with overnight lows in the 60s right along the lake, likely seeing some upper 50s as we get a little bit farther south away from that Lake Erie influence. Minimal rain chances through Wednesday, then a little bit of a spike here coming our way on Thursday as we reintroduce some of those late-day showers and likely a few thunderstorms into our forecast as well. About a 40% chance there, about another 30% on Friday. So seeing more of those late-day summertime pop-ups. Additionally, we're going to be bringing back the heat. Already by Wednesday, we're back up near 90, and for the weekend, we're going to be seeing temperatures right around there as well. Both Saturday and Sunday, I'm expecting a daytime high of 91. But heads up, with a surge in humidity coming our way later this week, those low 90s are actually going to feel more like mid to upper 90s during the afternoon. On Lake Erie, water temperatures in the 70s, light winds today out of the northeast, 5 to 10 knots. and 1 to 2 foot waves. Checking out that 7-day forecast, dry again tomorrow. Temperatures very nice, right around 80. But then we'll see that big spike in our temperatures coming our way Wednesday. A little dip there Thursday and Friday, but that's only due to increased rain chances during the afternoon. We're back in the 90s for the weekend. Overnight lows will be warming up significantly as well, only dropping into the 70s for the second half of the week.
Some people are just born entrepreneurs. They see an opportunity and then they go for it. Recent college graduate Isaiah Kelly fits that description to a T. Several years ago, Kelly discovered a market for hand-drawn custom sneakers. And before he even graduated from college, he built a business around one-of-a-kind works of wearable art. Take a look at his Ohio story.
Shoes or any sort of clothing, it's like a luxury item, but it's also, you know, some sort of a status. I don't want to have shoes that everyone else has. Everybody is just looking for, you know, that creativity or that self-expression outlet. My name is Isaiah Kelly. I am the founder of Smooth Creations, and we focus on cleaning, restoring, and customizing shoes for our clients. Going into my freshman year of college, I used to go on YouTube and just like type in, how can I get shoes for cheap? And so I came across like some 12-year-old kid painting a pair of shoes, and he was selling it for like $400 or $500 a piece. Me being a broke college student, I was like, man, that's something I can do easily. And going into summer of 2017, I worked at Walmart, I saved up, got the materials myself, and I started painting shoes. The very first pair of shoes I painted were a pair of Rainbow Huaraches. Typically, we have the shoes, we provide the shoes. All the shoes are brand new from different retailers. And typically, the sneakerheads, they typically know what they want. They know what design that they want. But a lot of times, we get people that don't really know what they want. So we offer just consultation, just talk about what their favorite things are, their favorite colors, hobbies, or maybe even their favorite cartoon character. And we're able to execute that and put them on shoes for them. I've worked on heels. I've done a pair of cleats that were in the NFL this past December. I've done basketball shoes. I've done Air Force One. A lot, just different ballet shoes, clogs, just all sorts of different materials I've been able to work on.
So this is Dragon Ball Z. So the magic code of this shoe, we have Dragon. But yeah, so this is actually my favorite custom.
I think what brings me the most joy is just the fact that, you know, somebody is not only willing to pay for a pair of shoes, but I've also been able to see some people wear my shoes. And I just think that's just really flattering that somebody's trusting with their vision and their creativity, and they're willing to represent it themselves. When I started, I did this alone. I was painting shoes by myself. I was also making our company website, handling sales, talking to customers. And so it was very, very difficult being able to do that and handle it. And I even lost some business because of it, just because it was difficult for me to respond in time because I had my hand in so many different pots. So that was just a big failure that I had to learn how to get through. And me having team members has really helped me with that.
So prepping and then taping is the most important, because if you don't prep it well, the paint's just going to fall off and it's not going to be wearable. Like, it saves you a lot of time if you tape off very well, because you won't have any touch-ups to do. And so, yeah, they're both very, very important steps before you start painting. Other than that, I typically don't. My favorite is just the painting process, just because it's fun.
I started in my garage and on my kitchen table customizing shoes. I didn't even know the things that I'm doing now existed, but I was able to, you know, hone in on a craft and, you know, being able to achieve something that was really, really cool. Especially, you know, doing this while being a college student, there was many very, very long nights and just weeks where, you know, it wasn't a lot of sleep, but I'm very passionate about it, and I love shoes, and I love what I'm able to do, so. My goal, honestly, right now, we do shoes, but we want to get into other sorts of apparel, just like t-shirts, hats, phone cases, wallets, just, we want to provide people with just a wide range of self-expression. Customizing shoes is something that I can honestly say that I do it every single day. It is something I love, and it's something that I take pride in. And so I would say that's the most fun part for me, is knowing that I have a passion for something, and I'm able to work for myself. I'm Isaiah Kelly, and this is my story.
Ohio.
Ohio Fun Facts are sponsored by the Ohio Senior Health Insurance Information Program.
Questions about COVID-19? Visit coronavirus.ohio.gov.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks so much for joining us here on Spectrum News One. I'm Mary Lee Melendez. Coming up this hour, going back to school. We ask teachers what they think about reopening schools and how they plan to follow health guidelines. And we'll have more on that story in just a moment, but first let's check in with meteorologist Ashley Beatty, who's in the Weather Center. And Ashley, pretty nice out there today. Hard to complain.
Yeah, really comfortable temperatures today, highs in the 70s and 80s, but heading into the middle of the week, we are going to be looking at not only the return of 90-degree temperatures, but also humidity back in the picture. Let's get right to your weather on the web. Puffy cumulus clouds out there today. For the vast majority of us, though, those will not be producing rain chances. Our odds of seeing showers today only around 10 to as much as 20%. Many of us are going to look like this through the afternoon. A few clouds dotting the skyline, but overall a pretty nice afternoon with high temperatures 70s to mid 80s, pretty much across the board. Best chance for any little spot showers we could see, largely going to be southeastern Ohio. And once we get into this evening, those rain chances pretty quickly wind down completely. And from there, a partly cloudy night with a little bit of patchy fog possible and pretty comfortable temperatures by early tomorrow morning. We'll see overnight lows for many of us falling down into the 60s. Some of us waking up to some crisp, cool 50s by early tomorrow morning, dropping to 59 Mansfield, Akron, coming down to 59 as well for Lima, Chillicothe. Now enjoy the relatively cool air while it's here, because we're going to be looking at 90s making a comeback to our forecast by Wednesday, and that heat will be sticking around. I'll have that weekend forecast for you coming up in just a few.
As the coronavirus numbers in dozens of states continues to surge, Ohio is still adding more than 1,000 new cases every day. The Ohio Department of Health is reporting more than 1,200 new cases across the state today.
It brings the total to nearly 67,000. The state is now averaging more than 1,000 new cases per day over the last 3 weeks. The number of new hospitalizations, meanwhile, are below 75 for the third straight day, and the number of new ICU admissions and deaths are also remaining relatively low. All these numbers come as Ohio reports just more than 18,000 new tests in a 24-hour span. Heading back to school in the fall will certainly look and feel a lot different this year. Our Tanisha Johnson talked with a couple of teachers about their excitement and concerns as their districts work to nail down a plan that follows state mandates and health guidelines.
There's a mixture of emotions about school starting this year. For teachers, that ranges from excitement to concerns for kids.
With a stopwatch in hand, Coach James Lawson is up and at him early with his players at Crestview High School in Conway, Ohio. He's trying to set the stage early with strength and conditioning training in preparation for what they hope will be an upcoming football season. As they practice, the 8th grade American history teacher is a little anxious about the new year.
We're really excited about getting back and seeing our kids, working with our kids, doing things as normal as possible.
While there's a level of excitement, Lockenheiser's got concerns about the best restart plan and safety.
We also have to think about the learning concerns and the challenges that our students might be bringing to the table.
Coronavirus.
It's like unemployment or underemployment.
Right.
And he, like others across the state, also concerned about the coronavirus and its impact as more waves of the virus are expected.
I'm hoping that a year from now, we don't have one of those stories that a student became very sick or worse, and the same for a staff member.
Greenlawn Junior Senior High School American Studies teacher and union representative Heather Stambaugh says some of her colleagues are on edge as the pressure to reopen mounts.
Looking at the numbers now, I have quite a few staff members who are living in fear, and then to be asked to come back at what looks like 100%, with masks and some social distancing, it adds extra anxiety.
Working on Google Classroom and classroom masks, Stambaugh says personally, she's also concerned about how she'll build relationships with students. That's in addition to how she'll make the necessary transitions with curriculum if they start school one way and then have to switch midstream because of the rise in COVID-19 cases.
I'll have like this really great moment of inspiration. I'll be very excited. And then the reality of, well, we don't know how long we're going to be face-to-face hits. And so it's like, well, I can't really channel my energy to that. And then you get sad.
And those concerns are just the beginning, as she and other teachers like James Lutzenheiser wonder how they'll engage with students effectively in a classroom 6 feet away. As both teachers prepare for the rollout of an official restart plan, they're looking to legislators to make the right decisions so that districts across the state don't come up short when school starts.
We need to make sure that there's enough financial resources and support for our school districts moving forward.
For now, they take it one day at a time, hoping they come out with a win. For Spectrum News, I'm Tanisha Johnson.
Columbus-based Improv Edge is one of the many businesses that have had to reroute due to COVID-19. CEO and founder Karen Huff says the group had to quickly restructure a business that has always operated in person. Improv Edge is a business training company that uses improvisation skills in its workshop. And the in-person sessions range from half a day to 9 months, but have now switched to 90-minute digital workshops. The company is in the top 1% of female-owned businesses in the United States and has won more than 10 awards over the years. Huff says it's their key principles that have guided them through the pandemic.
Our deepest value is that we have to be flexible and adaptable and be willing to improvise, and the pandemic was probably our greatest challenge to prove whether or not we can do that. I'll tell you, in 2 days, 95% of our clients either postponed or canceled their business with us in the space of 2 days. And we sat down virtually and started talking about what we could do.
The company is also now helping clients navigate the digital space, a service they hadn't offered before the pandemic. At least one major Ohio city will resume shutting off customers' water tomorrow. It comes as the state's EPA director sent a letter to mayors across the state giving them the green light to resume that practice. The director originally ordered shutoffs to be discontinued in March because of the pandemic. The Dayton Police Department says the city will resume shutoffs tomorrow, but both Cleveland and Cincinnati say they will not shut off water for delinquent payments at this point. Columbus's mayor, police chief, and several community leaders are noting a spike in violence across the capital city. Chief Thomas Quinlan says there have been 67 homicides to date across Columbus and 469 felony assaults. That's a 125% increase from last year. There were 8 shootings over the weekend, with 3 people killed on Saturday. Also, Quinlan says 4 police officers were violently assaulted over the weekend. Mayor Andrew Ginther says illegal guns are a threat to the people. He's calling on legislators at the state and federal level to take action, while Columbus's community leaders work to create opportunities for young urban men and women. The mayor of Toledo is now asking the Ohio Attorney General's office to begin the process of suspending 4 Toledo council members accused of bribery and extortion. Mayor Wade Kasakavich had set a Sunday deadline for council members Larry Sykes, Gary Johnson, Yvonne Harper, and Tyrone Riley to resign, but none of them did. All of them were arrested by FBI agents on June 30th. A federal complaint indicates more than $34,000 was at stake in the deals between the council members, business owners, and a Toledo attorney. Add the Parma City School District to the growing list of organizations considering changing their name. Parma High School's nickname is the Red Men. The district says it will host a series of Zoom meetings starting tonight and continuing over the next 6 weeks to let the community weigh in on whether it should be changed. The district superintendent says it's likely not feasible for any name change to take effect for the upcoming school year. Now that some emergency measures put in place to deal with the coronavirus pandemic are starting to expire, eviction cases are surging again across Ohio. A 90-day moratorium had been placed on eviction hearings across the state, but that has expired as of June 1st. Numbers suggest landlords continue to file eviction cases, and an estimated 503,000 Ohioans could not pay their rent in June. The U.S. Census Bureau says an additional 660,000 people were not sure if they would make their July rent. Governor DeWine last Thursday announced a $15 million grant to support